theme song for Vacation Bible School. We share together then in a time of pledges to the flags and to the Bible. And so we'll be there right now. We invite you to join with us. If you stand with us, we'll salute the American flag. We'll face the American flag, boys and girls. We'll stand straight and tall. And we'll salute with our hand over our heart. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Then we face the Christian flag, and we again stand in the call and we pledge with our hand over our heart. Let's pledge together. I pledge
allegiance to the Christian flag, and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands, one brotherhood, uniting all Christians in service and love.
And then right at the heart and right at the center of Vacation Bible School is the Bible. Back up here with me just a minute. There it is. The Bible is right at the mission of Vacation Bible School. And so we pledge and salute the Bible. So again, boys and girls, stand tall, salute with your hand over your heart, and let's face together. I pledge
allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word.
Day number five, on our last day, we learned that because
respect to all people. I want you to know we had, I guess I can say best group of boys and girls that I remember from Joy. They were so well behaved. We had no problems that I heard out throughout the week. We just had a good time together. Had the best staff that we've got thrown together this week. We just had great boys and girls this week. I just thank the Lord for a very successful vacation Bible school. But we couldn't do it if it weren't for you, the parents, allowing your children to come to be a part of vacation Bible school. So again, we thank you for this. Every day, though, we would go over our scripture. We had a particular scripture verse that we were learning, and I bet you Miss Lita, always ahead of us, it's Brother Joy. This was our scripture, and I'm going to have you say it with us this evening, okay? Now, the way we do it at Vacation Bible School, we begin by saying Deuteronomy 10:17. We want to know chapter and verse on this. And then we say the verse, and then we come back and we say where that verse is. Okay, do you have it? Well, we're going to try it out here together. Let's say it out real loud. Start with
Deuteronomy 10:17. The Lord your God is God of gods and Lord of lords, the great God, mighty and awesome. Deuteronomy 10:17.
Man, we needed the parents at Vacation Bible School, didn't we? Doing a great job tonight. Well, that was our verse, and it was just talking about how great and mighty and awesome God is, and isn't he? Amen. Isn't he?
Amen.
Yes, he really is. Well, we also had a motto that we said. It was a real simple motto. You'll see it behind me. Miss Alita always beat me to the point. And I bragged over and I got her that time. Our PBS motto was just simply one God, one Savior, and one Lord. Now, we tried sort of splitting this up a little bit every day. We're going to do it like we did one day in Vacation Bible School. You are going to be one God. This section is going to be
one Savior.
And everybody in the balcony and up here at the front, we're going to be one Lord. Okay? So we're going to start here, we're going to go here, and we're going to go here. But wait just a minute. What we're going to do is we're going to get a little bit of coffee, Brother George, I guess. Because when we say one Savior, I want you to throw your ones up in the air. One Savior. One God, excuse me, one Savior, and then one Lord, okay? And we'll point to our God and our Savior and our Lord, okay? Let's try it now one time.
One God, one Savior,
and one Lord. Amen. Let's give him the glory again. And then Brother George,
I think
I'll
do it again. I really do.
Well, let's do it again. Let's do it. We're going to swap it up, though. One
we began this process 6 months ago. And for me, this has been on my heart for at least the past 6 months, and I know several of the directors, it has been on their hearts and in their Bible study and in their prayers for the past 6 months. And for that, I thank you very, very much, because it would not have been possible if y'all had not studied, if you had not prepared, and especially your heart, to open your hearts, to open the doors of these churches to these children. And just to re-echo what Brother Curtis already said, if it weren't for you parents, we could not have had VBS, because we couldn't have had it if you did not share your children with us. And I love children, my heart is for children, and I thank you so much for letting them be a part of my life this week. Many of them I did not know, and a lot of them I got to know. Many of you workers I did not know, and I got to know you this week, and I have had so much fun. And a couple of the children that I babysit, that's what I do during my week, I babysit kids. And I thank my parents, there's some of them aren't here tonight, but I have one little boy that I kept, and I thank their parents for allowing me to bring their child with me up here, because that was an honor for me to be able to do that. And that they worked with me over the past couple of weeks, coming back and forth from the church, and they didn't mind me bringing their child up here with me. And that meant a lot to me. But I just want to say that this is an awesome church. This is a God-fearing church. We love the Lord here. And if you are looking for a church home, we would love to have you. Especially if you have children, we are trying very hard to get some great things going for our children. And as long as I'm here, I will be a part of it. And I tell you that publicly today, that I will be there. I have two children, and I want to make sure there's something here for me all the time. And on that note, I just want to ask that y'all would bow your heads and pray with me. Oh, before you pray, well, just so that I don't forget, because Brother Kirk told me not to forget to do this. Parents, please, after the children sing in a few moments, we want to invite you. Please don't leave until you go and see their classrooms. And go up and down the halls in the adult building and in the children's building. The kids have done a marvelous job this week. The teachers have done a marvelous job this week. They want to share that with you. So please, as soon as we conclude our program in here, please go and see their rooms. Go tour. As we said this week, we canoe in and out there. We canoe to crafts. We canoe to rec. We canoe to snacks. We canoe to music festival. We canoe to missions. So all of those rooms are in this building and in this building behind me. So please make yourself available to go to those and then join us for fellowship over in our gym. But if y'all would please just bow your head.